when did you first start working at the factory in North Tonawanda, New York?
I started working for Durez Hooker Chemical in 71, December 71.
Do you know what, where in North Tonawanda the Durez facility was located?
On Walk Road, North Tonawanda.
What was the business of the Durez plant when you arrived there in late 1971?
Making compound to make plastic.
And what was the nature of your first job assignment when you started working there on December 13, 1971?
According to this, the B Floorman.
Do you know what they mean, what this document means by Floorman?
Yes, B Floorman was a guy that really did everything.
Okay, and do you recall doing everything in that particular location when you first went to work at Durez?
Yes.
And in what department were you a B Floorman?
I started my job, I was in Building 88.
Now, what were your general duties while working in Building 88 for that period of somewhat less than a year? You told me you did just about everything. What is that? What is everything?
Everything. I worked as a mixer.
Mixing what?
Mixing raw materials.
What kinds of raw materials?
All different forms of raw material, like asbestos, dye, wax, wet flour.
Did those materials come in packages?
Yes, they came in bags.
Okay. What about the asbestos? What kind of container did the asbestos come in?
That was a bag.
And when you say that you mixed them, how did you mix them? And what kind of a container did you mix these raw materials?
Well, there was a typical mixing there. It was a big hole in the floor with a chute over it and a grate. We pour it down through that hole, mix it up. You know, well, the mix itself mixes it. But you have to put so many pounds of this, so many pounds of that in that material to make up the compound.
Now, one of the materials, raw materials that you would mix into the mixer was asbestos, is that correct?
Yes.
What did you do with the bags of raw asbestos in order to introduce them into the mixer?
We had a knife that we cut some open with, and then just dump them off in there.
And how long would it take you to open a bag and dump it into the mixer?
A couple seconds to rip it open and dump it off in there.
Where were you standing in relationship to the grate into which you introduced the raw material?
You're standing right at the gate, the grate.
And what would you see in the air when you dumped the bags of raw asbestos into the mixer?
Well, it always gave off dust, always. Especially if you dumped it too fast, it gives off more dust.
Do you believe that you were exposed to that dust when you were in this, in Department Building 88?
Yes, I do believe I was exposed to it.
Do you believe you were exposed to asbestos dust from materials handled by other people as well?
Yes, because there was always two mixers right beside each other.
Were there steam pipes running through the building?
Yes.
Were there other kinds of piping running through the building?
Yes, all kinds of pipes was running through the building.
Were you ever present when repair or maintenance work was done on those pipes?
All the time.
Can you tell me, please, what you observed when repair or maintenance work was done on the pipes running through the work area in Building 88?
Well, I could say we was present when the mechanics came over and worked on a pipe or whatever he had to do in there. We observed them working on that and putting stuff back together, you know.
What would you observe the mechanics handling? What materials were in their hands?
Well, they work tools, and like a lot of times when they had to take these pipes apart, there was always a time when they had to move back material, whatever that stuff was on the pipes.
Can you describe the stuff on the pipes?
It was sort of round type of stuff, like it was already made to go around the pipes. And like I said, most of the time that stuff is always in the way of the part that you got to take apart. And from that stuff, it always gave off dust, always.
Now, do you believe you were exposed to dust given off by the work that the mechanics performed on the coverings on the pipes?
Without a doubt, it was always dust.